I'm Trevin Wallace, born and raised in Wayne County.
Hey, we hot at
me,
girl.
Ride, boy. Go,
so I started playing football 7, 8 when we started playing flag, and I was always one of the best ones on the field.
Pitch outside to Trevin Wallace. He gets to the edge, down the sideline, gets a good block.
Being from Wayne County, like Jessup, Georgia, I heard like a lot of people say, oh, you ain't gonna get big schools, you from a small town. Oh, nobody gonna know who you is, you from Wayne County.
Roll up in the club. All eyes on me. All eyes on me.
Great backside pursuit player. He also plays a little downhill, which is really cool to watch. So for me, when I watch him play, I'm seeing shades of Ahmad Brooks.
Say they ready for one.
Staying down and re-blocking, not grabbing the holding by me. He just took Nathan Vickers and pushed him back 3 or 4 yards. Put his shoulder down and powered through about 3 or 4 Richmond Hill defenders.
Later, the future's in my eyes. Cause all I want is cash and things. I 5-0 bands for my flashy brains. Sue me like a dream. Been known to disappear before your eyes. It's like a dope thing. It seems my main thing was to be major pay. The game sharper than the razor blade. Save money, bring lies. One getting jealous of me. Die, depend on me like the first and 15. They might hold me for a second, but before they hit me, we got four and low riders and ski masks screaming thug like every time they pass. All eyes on me.
But then when I got high school in my 9th grade year, it was a whole different ball game. I'm with different people, people older than me, people better than me. Oh, Trevin ain't good for his size. Trevin not good, this and that. Trevin ain't good with people that's the same size as him. And I was like, dang, hearing this from everybody. You know, so you gotta have that mindset. You gotta go into work. Nobody can outwork you, no matter how old you is or how young. My 11th grade year, boom, I was doing good. Cause you know, your 11th grade year is the year that colleges come in and be like, oh, what can he do? His 11th grade year, what can he do? Oh, we're looking at him, this and that. But I had an injury. My 11th grade season over it. I was depressed. When I broke my ankle, I had nothing.
Right here. I remember this play like it was just yesterday. I'm at safety, you know, doing the usual back pedal, clean back pedal. I think it was either the quarterback or the running back had the ball. He had nowhere to pass. He got it, ran. So I'm like, okay, clean spot. So I hesitated a little bit. Now I ran, running. Boom, man in the hole. I try to pick him up. And my uncles always tell me, run your feet, Trevin, run your feet, run your feet. When I'm strong, I want to slam him. So I try to pick him up. And like when I picked him up, everybody, like teammates, all my teammates, know how we game tackle. They all just came and just landed on me. Boom. Everything just got quiet. My ears started ringing. And then I was just laying on the ground, like just right here. And then they were like, Trevin, get up, get up. And I was telling them, I was like, boys, I can't. Like, I can't move. So I'm just sitting there thinking, like, oh, I'm okay. Just a little bruise. It ain't that. And then I was like, they were like, can you get up and walk? I was like, yeah. So I tried to get him walk and I couldn't move. So then I'm sitting there. And then we got to the table. Coach White got me and we're sitting there and I was like, Coach White, am I gonna be okay? He just looked at me. He looked at me with like a face like, nah, everything ain't good. So he had went there and got some ice. My ankle was fat. He just looked at me and just started shaking his head. And I was like, just be real with me. What's gonna, is everything gonna be okay? He didn't tell me. So then I was sitting there. And I was like, nah, I was like, I'm good. So then he told me to take my stuff off, and I was like, why? He was like, you can't play no more.
I owe the tiger.
I got the torch, I can show you the way, you just follow the fight.
Action, how you gonna be one?
Eye of the tiger.
Eye of the tiger.
Once you believe it, then they gon' believe it, then you gon' inspire.
Bless.
Eye of the tiger.
Eye of the tiger.
Eye of the tiger.
Eye of the tiger.
I am a lover, I am a fighter, no more provider.
Yeah, I'm a provider.
Eye of the tiger.
Eye of the
I can just feel me get higher and higher and higher and higher. Buy the bag, booming like Metro. Start to get the feeling like retro. All about a dollar, no club flow. Pretty women love me like XO. Real tapping in a beast mode. Got the opposition looking petrol. Wake up every morning with the gusto. Came a long way from being cutthroat. How you going talking about it? I'm making 6-7 figures, running state to state, taking care of y'all. Got a lot of love from a fam, remember day one dogs. Can't believe we done split it up. Taking them trips overseas, now it's hard to believe. Living life like a dream, my man.
But that was
really
had
to trust and believe. Ain't no choice in between, I just can't intervene God's plans. You know, big dog lurking in his boots like Cujo. Young got a space like Mars, like Bruno.
Time to be great.
Trying to feel a couple cool bras.
Time to be great. Work for greatness.
Everybody kept saying, "Trevin, go get an X-ray, go get an X-ray, go get an X-ray." I was like, "Nah," because I was like, "I know if I get an X-ray," and in the back of my mind, I was like, "Something gonna be wrong," and I ain't with all that. So practice came. I'm dressed up, helmet, had stains on, and I had no ankle thing on, so I was running with a little limp, and then it got worse. And then Coach Adams, he was like, "Trevin," he was like, "You need to go get an X-ray because I ain't looking too good." So I was like, "Nah," he was like, "Just do me a favor. Run and cut at this." So every time I run, I cut, and it was like I'm about to fall. The next day, Coach Adams took me to Boner Joint, took an X-ray. They was like, "We need to put him in the boot." And I was like, "Only time they put somebody in the boot if something serious wrong." So they wanted to let me see my X-ray, and I was like, "Got some X-ray." They wanted to let me see it. So then I'm in my boot, go get it. That's when everything just happened. They was like, "Trevin, football over with for you." Yeah, I was like, "Nah, I can't be." They said the same thing that Tua did. Quarterback from Alabama, that's on Miami Dolphins. Same thing you did, and I was like, dang, I gotta start all over. I was depressed at the moment. I was real depressed. I was like, dang, football season really over? Like, it just got snatched away from me like that? I was like, dang, I gotta really do all this over again. So I gotta get my mobility back, my range of motion. It was like I was starting from day one. So I hit it, boom, physical therapy, going every day, boom, every day. Then I used to work out with my uncle, do something light to get my ankle back, right? And then I was like, okay, I'm straight. Then summer came. And then when summer came, I was like, I got to grind. I got to get back on my time. Like, so I came, summer, boom, doing everything fast. Drills, I'm first. Nobody want to go, I go first again. It was some days where my ankle used to be sore, and I was like, you know what? I'm finna just brush this off, because at the end of the day, no matter how sore it is or what it is, you got to work through it. So I was like, okay. Then my first game came. And I was like, we're going to really see how my ankle is. I made a tackle, and I got hit in it. I was like, all my whole legs got numb. And I was like, nah. I said, free, no, we ain't like this again. And then my uncle said, go get your ankle tape. Go get your ankle tape. So I got my ankle tape. And I was like, nah, it was just a little numb. You know, you ain't got hit in it so long. After that, everything was history. After I got out of surgery, I was like, hopefully I get to play again. The pandemic struck, boom. I was like, dang, glad that I got to play. Because at the end of the day, there's some teams out there that I didn't play at all. But we was fortunate to play. It wasn't the season that I wanted. It wasn't my senior year that I wanted, but at least I had to play.
Close to the end of my 11th grade year, my first offer from Illinois. They in the Big Ten. And I was like, okay, some people see me out there, but it ain't the big schools and all that. But I was grateful to have that. So then summer came. Boom, working out. Then NC State came, Boston College, Oklahoma State, Oklahoma, and I was like, okay, now I'm getting put on the map.
TREVIN WALLACE is a 4-star, but still under the radar, linebacker in this country. This guy is an absolute beast.
TREVIN WALLACE out of Wayne County, Jessup in Georgia. Number 6 rated player at his position, inside linebacker. Number 74 rated player, according to 247 Sports, regardless of position, number 74 in the nation, 8th-rated player in the great state of Georgia, which is loaded.
But then everybody just say, oh, Trevin, you under-recruited. You under-recruited. And I was like, I'm just blessed to be in this position. So then Auburn, Kentucky, Tennessee, and most SEC schools start calling me. And it was like, we will offer you, but we got to see your first few games. And I was like, okay. I got a chip on my shoulder, so, you know, I got the ball out. So my first game, boom, I played. And it was like, for you to have surgery, you to come recover, it's like you never broke your ankle or nothing. They're speaking real highly of me. And then South Carolina came, you know, my name is really getting out there now from Wayne County, just a small town. Everybody know everybody. And then, bam, I came as three-star. Kentucky offered me. South Carolina offered me. Tennessee offered me. Texas A&M offered me. Mississippi State. Reporters called me. I was like, Trevin, have you checked your rankings? And I was like, I really don't care about rankings because at the end of the day, it don't matter who you are. You can be a five-star, three-star. It depends how you show on the field. They said, you the 24th best inside linebacker in the nation. And I was like, dog, I ain't never played linebacker in a day of my life. And I was like, just them to say that, I think I'm real blessed to be in this position. A couple days later came, they said, go check it again. I was the 74th best recruit out of every single position in the nation. I was like, dog, I'm really putting my name out there. And I was like, only person I could think of that is God, because God put me in this position to show me that you got to put the man above first so you can accomplish everything. Because without him, you can't do nothing.
No. I remember that play in Long County when they threw that ball and I just mocked everybody. Remember that? That was far. Like in Long County. I don't know how far it was, but we were far. And it was like, just throw the ball. It was my 10th grade year. And it was like, just throw the ball to Trevin. No matter who was up, you know, who was beating them. He's like, just throw the ball to Trevin.
Talk about going to halftime.
Going to halftime.
It was there.
We was there.
That's what I'm saying. It's your first game at receiver.
Oh, they were like, first throw the ball at
him. Yeah, 93 yards.
They just throw it at him. I was like,
yeah, you lost it. Yeah.
I was running. And I just got up, just jumped over him, got it, and scored. Man, if you seen everybody in the crowd going crazy, like they was like, damn, never seen that happen before. Like it was like this Hail Mary pass. Like everybody on our sideline was just going crazy, jumping. Just like, I was like, oh, I really did that? I was like, dang.
Without a shadow of a doubt, nobody can say he didn't leave everything that he had on the field, because he definitely did. So, I mean, as that, you know what I mean, it's a proud moment just seeing what he was able to accomplish, man. It just let me know that I have to take a lot of these kids who want to follow the same path, you know, and basically put them through the same thing that he did, let them know that Trevin just didn't wake up, put cleats on, and was a great football player. You know, he worked hard day in and day out. You know, he wasn't afraid to put the grind in. And, you know, that's why he was able to have the opportunity that he has now.
As a guy that's a super athlete at the linebacker spot, someone who could play a little bit of running back, could split out as a slot wide receiver for you, but you're going to put him on the defensive side of the ball and ask him to go track down running backs. And certainly this guy is a tracker. Call him the Revenant. This guy is on the hunt. He knows where he's going. He knows how to find running backs and get them down on the ground.
6'2", 209, committed to Boston College in June, but then decommitted in late November. He's opened up his recruiting, Trevin Wallace has, to Auburn, Kentucky, LSU, Ole Miss, and BC is still in the mix. This is the scouting report on Trevin Wallace. Could need some time to adjust to playing one spot full time. He's been all over the field. Potential to fit multiple defensive schemes as a natural run and hit linebacker with athleticism to develop consistent coverage ability. Possesses outstanding overall profile for an off-ball linebacker projection given high school versatility and proven playmaking ability. Could prove to be an early round NFL draft ceiling. Once again, that's on Trevin Wallace, inside linebacker, one of the best in the land.
He is known as a big hitter with tremendous speed and overall athleticism. He is currently ranked as the 74th best player in the nation. At 6'2", 210 pounds, he was once committed to Boston College, but he is currently entertaining offers from several other Power 5 schools, including Auburn, Ole Miss, South Carolina, and Oklahoma. Our 912 Sports Gibson Animal Clinic Defensive Player of the Year for 2020 from the Wayne County Yellow Jackets, Trevin Wallace.
Speaking of helping Kentucky, what do you hope to accomplish as a Wildcat?
A lot. I hope this. I want to be my freshman year. I want to go and start off rip. You know, I want to help them win games. You know, probably even go to the championship. But I want to help them a lot.
Do you have a message for Kentucky fans?
BBN, go Wildcats.
First up, the Cats landed one of America's top recruits on National Signing Day when four-star linebacker TREVIN WALLACE chose the Cats over Georgia, Ole Miss, Auburn, and Florida State. Only two other players ranked higher than the South Georgia product. WALLACE, who comes in at 6'2", 220, is the number 35 overall player in the 2021 recruiting class. Here's what WALLACE told rivals following today's announcement.
I come into Kentucky. And the three reasons, like, the reasons I want to go to Kentucky is because I have a good connection with John Sorrell. Like, the connection is real, and it's good with my parents. And plus, the opportunity there, oh, it's great. It's a great opportunity there. And then third of all, it's like, Nike is my favorite brand, so I couldn't go nowhere with that. BBN, Big Blue Nations, go Wildcats.
Josh, this is a big get for the Cats. I mean, this is one that somehow Georgia lets him out of the state, and he comes to the Wildcats, four-star linebacker.
Wayne County don't got a good football team. Y'all always go out second round. They was telling me like, oh, you ain't gonna be recruited good, none of that, because we in a small town. So I was like, okay. I started getting stuff, everybody started coming in, then people was like, oh, you doing good, this and that. And they were showing fake love. And I was like, okay, I hear them. But at the end of the day, it was going over my head because back then they was like, oh, you from Wayne County. You ain't getting nothing. You ain't getting nothing unless you go to camps. And I was like, I ain't had to go to a camp to earn the stuff I got. It's not y'all on the field doing that, the work. It is me. So at the end of the day, I put my stuff out there so people can come see me and see who I am and see what I work for.
Hey, man. Hey, look. Now I ain't perfect, but my little sister think I'm so I ain't changing what you see, what you get. Waiting for me to give up and stop. Yeah, right, you wish. Need to get out my. I was missing the big picture. Switched my whole frame of mind, now I'm open. Shout out, I can't afford now to focus. Don't wanna go back to the days I was hopeless. I was broke, but I still wasn't broken. Still remember what Touche had told me. Don't let no hard times ever make you soft spoken. Thought if ain't nobody got me, he got me. They hit him with a charge and a shot me. I ain't talking Sylvester alone, but I felt all alone when that shit they got rocky. Thought I would drown, guess they ain't know I'm too cocky to stop me. Plus I'm good in that water like lock me. Used to think I can't do it, then watch me. All my life it would rain and pouring. Now I'm rocking them stages, touring. Got so used to the pain it was foreign. The smile, now I'm up in the game, I'm scoring. Never wanted the fame and fortune. Trials and tribulations made a necessity. Trying not to let the light get the best of me. I just feel like God constantly testing me.
Swag keep them angels calling my name like. Yeah, can't know what joy feel like unless you feel some pain. Don't know the sun gon' shine unless you see some rain. Maybe I'm going insane, swear I keep hearing them angels calling my name like. Yeah, can't know what joy feel like unless you see some pain. Don't know the sun gon' shine unless you see some rain. Look how far we got to go, look how far
I got that me for me tattered as a reminder that this life ain't forever. So every day I'm breathing, I'ma be better than before. I ain't never been scared to war with whoever, except for that man in the mirror. Cause I know he know me like the pot know the kettle. Too busy pioneering for me to settle down. Gotta play the game to beat the game. I'm at a new level now. Hating, been underrated, so got long. I don't care how y'all rate me. Talk to God on the daily. Give a shout. Saying, hear me loud and clearly. Keep that bull off from near me, bruh. Cause before I let you fuck up my life, you gon' have to kill me. My life do it 365 times on a fuck yearly. Just so people near me can numb they pain. You gotta feel me, hold up. Long as my mama good, I'm good as can be. That little bread ain't no dope, but look like Cuba gooding to me. Nah, I ain't made enough yet to get my boys out the hood. But once I do, y'all ain't gon' be able to say nothing to me.
Swag keep hearing them angels calling my name like. Yeah. Know what joy feel like unless you felt some pain. Don't know the sun gon' shine unless you seen some rain. Maybe I'm going insane, swear I keep hearing them angels calling my name like. Yeah, can't know what joy feel like unless you seen some pain. Don't know the sun gon' shine unless you seen some rain. Look how far we got to go, look how far we done came. Angel on my right shoulder, devil sit on my left. When as I welcome all the changes, this life throws in my direction. Who needs a mirror to see a reflection? I see myself, even when the world is dark. And I can't see anything else, I done felt it all. Every emotion, every sensation, living prisoner in my mind in a cell of my own creation. I wanna escape it, but then again I don't, because this made me everything I am. I just pray I never forget.
tough times don't last, only tough people do. I'm gonna be put through so many obstacles and courses. At the end of the day, it's you to stand there and sit there and be like, I'm finna push through this and keep going. If you're back against the wall, keep pushing. Because if you don't keep pushing, then you give up on yourself, and that's not good in life. Tough times don't last, only tough people do, and I think of that every time.